The chemists who discovered pagodane described it simply but accurately. This is a highly complex, aesthetically pleasing molecule. Most of you know that this is already reason enough for organic chemists to waste years of their lives in pursuit of a synthesis. With natural products, we often have promising biochemical activities as an additional incentive. But as you might have seen with the cubanes we covered on this channel, the value of synthesis can also be less obvious. In the pagodane story, there are plenty of surprises to uncover. We will start our video with looking at an old-school synthesis of pagodane and understanding its connection to the mysterious dodecahedrane, a mini fullerene if you will. And then we will discuss aromaticity. Does pagodane look like benzene, for example, to you? If so, please get your eyes checked. But you will be shocked to learn that we actually have a special case of aromaticity here as well. Pagodane got its name due to resembling an Asian tiered pagoda tower. I think we all agree it's quite handy to not have to spell out its full name every time. To understand pagodane synthesis of 1987, we need to know some stuff about the compound isodrin. Isodrin is an isomer of aldrin, the name clearly due to the Diels-Alder reaction used in its synthesis. Aldrin is a very potent insecticide, which after decades of widespread use and a ballpark production quantity of 270 million kilograms, was revealed to be neurotoxic and potentially carcinogenic in humans, as well as extremely toxic for aquatic life. You can imagine with all the chlorines in it, it leads to persistent pollution and bioaccumulation in the environment. This was bad for the fishies, but good for the team of chemists around Professor Prinzbach, who had easy access to the isomer isodrin. By now you might have realized that this could be a great starting material as it comes with the proper 5-5 framework, forming the bottom of pagodane. The whole synthesis is very efficient and, as they boldly put it, leaves no room for further optimization, so you are in for a nice ride. Starting from isodrin, you will not be surprised that they kicked things off with a Diels-Alder reaction. Cycloaddition of the less hindered double bond with this diene introduced additional carbons to the system, which were converted to a benzene ring via a few steps. Acidic hydrolysis of the acetal uncovered the ketone, which upon heating released CO to give the cyclohexadiene at 110 degrees. The intermediate actually immediately undergoes an intramolecular transannular hydrogen transfer to create an aromatic ring. What a nice reaction. Dehalogenation with lithium then removed the chloride groups and actually regenerated the double bond at the other bridge. They basically repeated this sequence with some tweaks next. This time they had to dehalogenate the cycloadduct first, this time with sodium, before hydrolysis and release of CO. Going to this step with chloride still intact led to significant decomposition. Now, while you might think dehydrogenation and creation of a second benzene ring is very much preferred, the steric shielding of the inner protons made this step very challenging for the chemists. After numerous attempts, they were successful with drastic conditions of palladium over charcoal at 250 degrees Celsius. Maybe you're now wondering why we would even create this intermediate. Well, not only is it symmetrical and has the carbons we need to build pagodane anyways, but remember there is a central four-membered ring in the target product. Thus, a 2 plus 2 photo addition did the trick, and as we saw, for example, in Canatech's propylene synthesis, this reaction can be de-aromative as well. Now the top part of pagodane remains. Another Diels-Alder reaction with the reactive maleic anhydride introduced two additional carbons and triggered an intramolecular cycloaddition to create a 6-6 ring system on top. So basically we have one carbon too much at the moment. But if you watch my previous video on cubanes, for instance, you will know that ring contractions are a thing. Hydrolysis and decarboxylation gave a symmetric diene intermediate, which was hydroborated and oxidized to a mix of different isomers. Now they could introduce alpha diazo groups on both ketones, setting the stage for a photo-Wolf reaction, which led to a 6-5 ring contraction via carbenes. Amazingly, this proceeds in almost quantitative yield and, according to the authors, led to precipitation of colorless needles within the solution. Must have been amazing when they witnessed this for the first time. Because the ketene intermediate was captured by the methanol solvent, we now have two methyl esters which we can get rid of via hydrolysis and decarboxylation. In this case, they performed a decarboxylative iodination and dehalogenated the product to ultimately access pagodane. Even though it's highly strained, it showed to be quite thermally stable. The two key references give a nice in-depth breakdown of other structural analysis and all the reaction steps and troubleshooting, so I highly recommend checking it out, as I definitely didn't cover everything here. Before we continue, I wanted to briefly thank my channel members for their support. If you like these videos, please make sure to activate notifications and subscribe, and consider becoming a channel member if you'd like. So now that we've seen this very efficient and elegant synthesis by Prinzbach and co-workers, let's answer how this is connected to another nice molecule, dodecahedrane. The answer is quite easy, they are isomers. There was quite some mystique around this molecule. Again, you can see the paper is incredibly well written and makes for some nice bedtime reading. All these pagodane efforts from Prinzbach were aimed at ultimately converting it to dodecahedrane. The catalytic conversion of this was brilliantly successful but also disappointing. Even with optimal conditions, they could not get higher yields than 3-8%. This obviously made in-depth investigations of dodecahedrane impossible, so they had to figure out another way. If normal pagodane doesn't work, you must harness reactivity of functional groups. After various attempts, they ultimately tried it with this derivative with a disconnected central four-membered ring. Leveraging fluoride as a small base was critical to deprotonate the sterically inaccessible protons and initiate intramolecular SN2 reactions to create the important bond connection which previously was so unpreferred. Reduction of the central double bond which was present in the derivative and decarboxylation then gave dodecahedrane in much better yield. However, Prinzbach was not the first to synthesize dodecahedrane. This was achieved by Leo Paquette 5 years earlier in 1982 already. This second synthesis delivered much higher quantities of the product though, and thus was arguably even more important. You can read more about the subsequent studies on dodecahedrane in the paper as well. Some really interesting stuff, for example, expansion to fullerenes. Last, let's talk about this unique aromaticity phenomenon. They found upon treating pagodane with superacids, it was oxidized to a remarkably stable dication that preserved its original symmetry. This was quite shocking, as at least from a high-level perspective, pagodane is purely aliphatic, so why would it stabilize this dication? This is a case of a 2-electron 4-center pi system, in this setting called sigma-bishomoaromaticity. This is pretty cool as the pi orbitals overlap across the pagodane center, reinforcing the central shorter C-C bonds while still keeping some interactions across. The pi orbitals in this case actually lie within the plane of the cyclobutane ring. And with 2 pi electrons, remember Hückel's rule, this qualifies as a quasi-aromatic system. I will leave you with this nice epilogue from the paper. Very dramatic and slightly existentialistic, but maybe something you can relate with if you're doing science yourself. I hope you enjoyed this old but gold synthetic chemistry. Please activate notifications so you don't miss the next one, and consider becoming a channel member if you like the videos. Let me know any specific suggestions you might have that could be interesting for the broader community. Thank you and until next time.